This is the season. My name is Wensley. My partner is Frank Jones. The chief is Captain Kellogg. December the 24th, Christmas Eve, they brought in a guy named Grudge. When I heard what they booked him on, my blood ran cold. It was a 409-6325-096704. Not believing in Santa Claus. 4:35 p.m. I was working the holiday watch at a homicide with Frank.
Hang up your stocking yet, Joe?
Yeah, just before I come down. You too, Frank?
Always do. Hung it up early just in case I have to work late tonight. Wouldn't want to miss out when Santa Claus comes, you know.
Sure wouldn't. Be a shame.
What you gonna do tomorrow, Joe? What you gonna do on Christmas? You got any plans?
Nothing much.
Why don't you come by the house, Joe? We're gonna have Christmas dinner. You know, all the trimmings. Turkey, celery stuffing, oysters maybe, chestnuts. All the trimmings. Cranberry sauce. Love to have you. The missus always fixes a plate of relish with them little carrot sticks. You know, olives, pickles, scallions. Most folks call them green onions, but they're really scallions. Did you ever notice that, Joe?
Ever notice what, Frank?
How most folks call them green onions, but they're really scallions.
Scallions.
Anytime after two, Joe. Love to have you.
Well, I'll see.
Love to have you.
Well, I'll see.
The missus always fixes a plate of relish with them carrot sticks. You know them little carrot sticks? Olives, pickles, scallions.
Let's not go through that again.
Love to have you. Go through what again, Joe?
How most folks call them green onions, but they're really scallions.
Oh. You noticed that too, huh, Joe?
Homicide Wednesday.
What's the matter, Joe? What's the matter, Joe?
Bringing a guy in a 409-6325-096704.
You mean?
Yeah. Guy don't believe in scallions. I mean, Santa Claus. 6:29 p.m. We questioned the guy who didn't believe in Santa Claus, a guy named Grudge. Says here your name's Grudge, is that right?
Yeah.
You said you didn't believe in Santa Claus?
It's hard to believe what you said. Did you really say that?
Sure I said it. How do you know there's a Santa Claus? You got a picture of him?
No, no mugshot.
Any fingerprints?
No latent prints. I just know that's all. It's like saying there isn't an Easter bunny.
That's another guy there ain't no of.
Well, that's your story, mister.
Joe, he just said that to make me feel bad, didn't he? There really is an Easter bunny, isn't there, Joe?
Listen, Grudge, didn't I pick you up 3 years ago in a 1492 for not believing in Columbus?
Yeah, I don't believe in Cleveland or Cincinnati either.
How about Toledo?
I ain't made up my mind yet about Toledo.
Okay, mister, I get the picture now. You don't believe in nothing, do you?
Nothing. And you want to know something else?
What's that?
I'm going to get up and I'm going to walk right out of this room, because you guys ain't got nothing on me. There ain't no law against not believing in Santa Claus.
There is in my book. Let me tell you something, mister. I'm going to prove there's a Santa Claus if it takes me all night.
Pretty funny. The police department's got nothing else to do.
Let me straighten you out, buddy. This one's on Frank and me. Right, Frank? Right, Frank?
There really is an Easter bunny, isn't there, Joe? You know, hippity-hopping down the bunny trail?
I took Grudge over to the helicopter, got in, flew around the city for hours. I showed him department stores. What's hurrying in and out of those department stores, Grudge?
Happy people! But I ain't impressed!
I showed him stockings. How are those stockings hung, Grudge?
By the chimney with care, but I didn't hang none up!
I showed him children, nestled all snug in their beds. What's dancing in their heads, Grudge?
Visions of sugar plums! But you ain't selling me! There ain't no Santa Claus!
He still didn't believe. There was only one thing left to do. My job. Get to the North Pole. 11:45 p.m. We arrived at the North Pole. I set the plane down. We walked over to Sandy's workshop. Rang the bell. Pardon me, sir. Can I ask you a few questions?
Why, sure. Just tickle me to death.
What do you do for a living?
I'm a brownie.
What are you doing at the North Pole with a southern accent?
Well, the boss sort of ran short on help this year, so he had to recruit a few of us brownies from the South Pole.
That figures.
What a waste of time.
Could we talk to your boss, please?
Oh, he's out. You would come on the one night he's out in the whole year.
What's your particular job, Mr. Brownie?
My boss has 8 tiny reindeer. My job? Feed them.
Yes, sir. What do you feed them?
Well, most times I fix up a little plate of relish. Olives, pickles, and them carrot sticks. You know them little old carrot sticks? And scallions.
Most folks call them green onions, but they're really scallions.
How do you know?
Just a stab in the dark. The little man showed us through the workshop.
My boss will be back for the second load pretty soon. Say, would you all like to hear an interesting story?
Yes, sir.
Will you see that huge pile of presents over there?
Man, look at all that stuff.
Would you believe it? They're all for the same man, been piling up here year after year.
Why didn't the guy ever get them?
Yeah, why?
Because he didn't believe in my boss. You know the rules.
Mm-hmm, we know.
I don't suppose there's no chance that this guy can still...
Get the presents? Oh, sure. He gets them all, the minute he believes. But I don't suppose he ever will.
Too bad about that guy. What's his name?
Don't say it. I don't want to hear it.
Come on, Mr. Brownie, what's his name?
His name? Grudge.
The Brownie saw us to the door, wished us a Merry Christmas. We were heading back to the plane when it happened.
Hey!
Yeah, Grudge?
You know that guy I said I didn't believe in?
Who's that?
Santa Claus?
Yes, sir.
You think I'm too old to change my mind?
You're never too old, Mr. Grudge.
Well, then I believe in Santa Claus and Columbus.
How about Cleveland, Cincinnati, and the Easter Bunny?
Yeah, them too.
And Toledo?
I still ain't made up my mind yet about Toledo.
Look, Grudge, up in the sky. He's coming back for the second load.
It's Santa Claus! It's Santa Claus!
There's the only guy I know can make everybody happy in one night.
Yeah. He must have the biggest heart in the whole world.
That's about the size of it.